Hello, Internet. You are listening to Con Talk, episode number 73. This is going to be my Otaku Fair / Game Expo post-game show, or maybe I should just call it my Otaku Fair post-game since I didn't do a lot of gaming outside of keeping my name on top of the Time Pilot arcade machine. Otaku Fair took place November 3rd through the 5th at the Hilton San Antonio Hill Country Hotel and Spa. Beginning from the top, registration was a breeze. There was no line. I just walked up and told the folks at the Otaku Fair table that I was a panelist. They asked for ID, which I provided, and I got my comp badge. Pretty cut and dry. No problems there. There wasn't really an artist alley at Otaku Fair per se. The artists, some of the other guests, and other assorted weirdos like those San Japan people were placed in the hallways of the hotel, which occasionally got a little cramped on Saturday. The dealer's room was small but had a nice assortment of folks selling stuff. Before I talk about panels, I'd like to take the opportunity to mention Lisa Rinaldi, the public relations and programming organizer for Otaku Fair. She was very helpful not only in scheduling the panel beforehand, but in helping out during the event and getting the word out about it via social media, so big thumbs up for her. I had a small yet enthusiastic group for Furry 101. The room was a little less than ideal due to the windows. I had to turn off the lights in order to be able to see my projector image, but otherwise, you know, it was all good. Remember how I said in the pregame that this felt like two cons? It really was two cons. There was a separate table to pick up your Game Expo registration. Both cons had their own con books. Yeah, it felt a little weird. Okay, weirder. That said, everybody seemed to be having a good time, and I would describe the event as small but enjoyable. Now we get to the bad stuff, and I'm just going to say it. This hotel was not very good for this event. From what I could see, Otaku Fair / Game Expo was lightly attended, and the hotel wasn't even big enough for the folks that did show up. The con was widely spread out around the first floor, which kind of had a funky layout that made the lack of a map and signage much more noticeable. There wasn't enough parking, because as soon as somebody pulled out of their spot on Saturday, it was almost immediately taken, and I even saw vehicles parked in fire zones. Not good. Otaku Fair also printed out their schedule on handouts that made it a little hard to figure out what time the events were taking place. Lisa ended up roaming the halls with a megaphone announcing upcoming panels, which seemed to help. Our friends across the pond in the UK have a saying, "It does exactly what it says on the tin." And that pretty much sums up Otaku Fair, or at least the parts that I was involved with. Much like Alamo City Furry Invasion, they did the best with what they had and they were able to put on a decent little show with some issues that didn't detract too much from the main experience. I am hopeful that next year's event will be better once they get a new hotel and some properly done schedules, maps, and signs. That'll do it for the review, and it now comes with a little sadness that I must announce that this will likely be the last episode of Con Talk. I would like to thank all of my friends that have joined me along for the ride. Chris Holm, Damon Cohn, Dave Henken, Schechter, Wolfboy, Pappy Puma, Akari, Elric, AJ, Joel, and Soltero D. Ramirez. I would also like to give a big thank you to all the staff members and volunteers that helped put these conventions together. One of the goals of this show has always been to provide constructive criticism so that things can be made better for everybody, and I would like to think that we did a good job of that. You can check out my other podcasts, short stories, and blog posts on EduardoSoliz.com or follow me on Twitter as Randomizer9. I am Eduardo Soliz, and this has been Con Talk. Thank you for listening.